My first guest is a YouTube fitness star with over 100 million views on her YouTube channel. She's now also the author of Get Skinny Again, The Right Exercises to Get Back Your Dream Body, and The Secrets to Living a Fit Life. I am joined by YouTube fitness star who is known as Sarah Fit, Sarah Dussault. Hi, Sarah. How are you today?
Hi, good, thanks. How are you?
I'm great, and thank you for coming on the program. Now, first, I'm curious, when you decided that you wanted to create your YouTube channel, how did you decide for that to be the outlet to reach out to people with fitness?
So I actually answered a Craigslist post from a company called diet.com in 2006, and that was when YouTube first started, and they wanted someone to create videos for their website, and YouTube had just started, so it seemed like a natural fit to host them on YouTube. And I wanted to be a broadcast journalist. I was working as a PA for NESN, which is the New England Sports Network, where all the Red Sox games are played. So I first started actually producing videos for a company. I had a boss, and they started being pretty successful. And a couple years after I saw how much money could be made on YouTube, I decided to take a plunge and start my own channel and start working for myself full-time about a year or two later.
Well, that sounds very exciting, and I mean, with over 100 million views, it definitely has worked out for you, and now you've got this book out, which I must say, I love the breakdown of the book. It's not just a book about fitness or a diet. It's a mixture of everything and really fitting it into just about anyone's life.
Yeah, and when I kind of started out with my own business, you know, I went for the name Sarah Fit because I may not always eat the right thing, but I love to work out, and it really is something that I enjoy doing. A lot of people don't, so I tried to make it a little bit easier for people in the book to try to find something that, you know, works for them. So, you know, in the book, if you like to work out at a gym, there's a schedule for you. If you like to work out at home, there's a schedule for you. If you love group exercise classes, you can work those into the schedule that I provide in the beginning of each kind of chapter. And also, of course, the people who don't have any time at all, there are 10-minute workouts for them as well.
And that's something that I feel like is a big excuse for people. It's not having that time to work out. So even if it's at the office taking a 10-minute break, that's nice that you do have that option.
Yeah, and I say in the book, you know, if you're going to follow my plan for weight loss, doing the 10-minute workouts all the time isn't going to get you there. But if you need to do one or two a week, that's fine. Just keep your body moving. Your body almost becomes addicted to exercise. Not addicted in a negative way, but almost like it wants to move. It loves those endorphins that your body gets from exercising, and so it kind of, you know, pushes you along. If you keep doing it regularly, you're never going to want to stray for longer than 2 or 3 days because you're going to miss how good your body feels when you do exercise.
Well, now, since 2014 isn't that far away, and a lot of people, when they make their New Year's resolutions, make it to do with something with health or weight loss, what are some ways for those beginner people to start, whether it is with that at-home workout or something in the gym?
Well, I definitely recommend that people start out small and they create attainable goals in small increments. So, you know, signing up for something like a lot of studios in Boston where I live have these unlimited monthly membership trial periods. And so, you know, you get a discounted rate for a month and you get to go as many times as you want. So people that are trying to get back into it, I really recommend almost working out, you know, consistently for the first 10 days to kind of get your body to start being addicted to it. And again, you don't have to work out hard all those 10 days. One of those days can just be a nice walk, or two or three of those days can just be like that. But having small attainable goals and saying something like, I'm going to work out, you know, 7 days within the first 2 weeks of 2014. That's a small goal, and it's attainable. And so when people are first starting out, they kind of get overwhelmed. And so to kind of break things down week by week almost and just set small goals and trying to find an exercise program that they love, that's probably the biggest challenge. And that's also why I recommend, you know, those 30-day kind of trial periods, or even some yoga studios will offer 2 weeks. So find something that you think you might like. Try it out without having, you know, this huge commitment like some of the gyms have. And if you don't like it, try something else. But really, people need to find something that they love. And lastly, you're never going to out-exercise a poor diet. So a lot of people think that as soon as they start working out, the weight's just going to come off and they don't have to really change what they're eating. And that is not true at all. If you only have the opportunity to eat better or exercise, I would say eat better because, you know, a cookie at Starbucks is like between 200 and 300 calories. That's a 30-minute jog. So.
Yeah. And I did notice that what you were saying about making sure that that diet fits with the workout, I notice in the book a lot of times you say, especially when it talks about the abs, that the abs are made in the kitchen. It's not just doing all of the core workouts that you can do.
Oh, yes, yeah. There are definitely ways to get definition at the gym, but really most of us are going to put weight on in our midsection kind of first. And that's also kind of where it comes off first for a lot of people as, wow, not everybody, everyone's different. And, you know, some people, they're not going to ever see abs, and that's just a body type. But your abs are definitely made in the kitchen. Eating a clean diet, which I talk about in the book, I give a lot of recipes that are simple and easy. But basically, eating a clean diet is eating things that don't have a lot of processed ingredients, or they don't have any ingredients at all. Things that are natural, come from the ground. You know, your lean proteins. I try to steer clear of eating a lot of those packaged foods because those chemicals and all the processed foods, those are what are going to latch onto your belly.
And some of the processed foods tend to trick us. They tend to make us think that they're light and they're better for us, but they're not as good as going for more of the natural foods that we know everything that's going to be in it.
Yeah, and I talk about that. In the book, I have a shopping list. So people that kind of have never really gone grocery shopping before, so I kind of had in mind, you know, a college student who had always relied on their parents doing their grocery shopping, or maybe they're young adults and they're grocery shopping for the first time. That grocery list is going to give them an idea of things that they should be putting in their cart. You know, instead of grabbing those chips as a snack, grab some almonds, grab some hummus, some carrots. There are alternatives to the processed garbage. And most of the garbage that we eat comes in the form of snacks and when people are kind of eating those already prepared dinners. So the recipes in the book are really simple and they're affordable too.
And one thing that I noticed you don't hesitate to use in your recipes is protein powder. And I wanted to get your perspective on that because I hear a lot of girls talk about how they're afraid to use protein powder because they think that it's going to bulk them up when that's really just a myth.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, I hate that myth. I hate when people say that because it's so true. A lot of girls won't, you know, lift heavy weights because they don't want to bulk up. That is not true. Females do not have enough testosterone to bulk up. You know, maybe one in 1,000 does have enough testosterone to do that, but most of us do not. So protein powder is something that I really enjoy, and it's sweetened. So I try to steer clear of sugar, but protein powder is one of the few times I kind of allow myself to eat sweet things. It's really versatile. It's not going to bulk you up. Some of my favorite ones come from all natural resources like Vega or even my friends who have toned it up. They have their own perfect bit. The vegan protein powder tastes a little different because it's not coming from animal source protein like whey. Whey is going to be a little bit more creamy, and people might find the vegan protein powders to taste a little chalky. But the Vega one is definitely my favorite tasting, and you're not going to bulk up. It's just a way to get protein after your workout so that your muscles can repair themselves. You can get stronger without getting bulkier in a more efficient way. So I used to strength train a ton and wasn't doing, like, the proper post-workout nutrition, and I really wasn't seeing results. As soon as I changed that, I started seeing more definition. The exercise started getting easier, and I lost weight.
Now, one thing with protein powder that I've noticed is when you put it with, say, a smoothie, it also helps you to feel fuller longer, so you don't feel that urge to snack quite as much.
Oh, yeah, of course. It's delicious, and it does help you feel full until lunch. I had someone tweet at me the other day that they tried one of my favorite smoothie recipes in the book, and they said it kept them full from breakfast all the way up to lunch, and they didn't eat any snacks at all.
Perfect. So that's another reason for women to not really be scared of that protein powder because it won't bulk them up and it won't make them look almost like a guy.
Yeah. No, it will not.
Now, what were some of your favorite workouts that you put into the book that maybe it's a good thing for a beginner to start with, especially if they haven't been to the gym in a long time and that's their New Year's resolution?
So I would say for the beginners, some of the cardio workouts are my favorite. They're all kind of my favorites. I chose my favorite moves, things that show results. But if you are a beginner, I would say maybe start out with just body weight exercises. So starting with the home section might be a good place to start, but you can do those workouts at a gym. So a lot of the home workout moves do not require any equipment, which is great for beginners, low risk of injury. But you can do all of the home workouts at a gym. So that is a great place to start. You don't have an excuse not to hit one of those workouts. And with everything, go to the best of your ability. If there's a move that is too challenging, if you're at a gym, you can ask a trainer for a modification. You can tweet at me and ask me for a modification, and I'll give one to you. They're all pretty simple, and they're explained, and there are advanced progressions for some of them, and even modified versions for beginners. So I would definitely recommend someone to start with the home section, doing the body weight exercises. Again, you can do them at the gym. And with the cardio, they're all my favorites. But go to the best of your ability. If I suggest a speed on a treadmill that's too fast, go as fast as you can go comfortably. And just make sure that when it's a hard interval that you're pushing yourself.
It sounds like a great option. Now, for someone who, once they've done those workouts, if they want to challenge themselves a little more, what would be a good point in that workout to know if they can maybe add a little bit of weight or do one of the more advanced versions?
Yeah, in the book there are advanced versions that are kind of explained. So once you kind of do the workouts for a little bit of time and they're starting to get easier, once you notice you're not getting sore the next day, that's when it's time to kind of change things up. Either increase the weight, speed up the how fast you're doing the exercises. You can also, increase the amount of reps, or you can increase the amount of sets. I recommend increasing the weight. You're not going to bulk up, and that's the quickest way to really burn out those muscles and get results.
And that is what a lot of people want. The results may not come instantaneous, but they will come through time.
Yeah, they will.
Now, where can people go to pick up a copy of your book, Get Skinny Again?
It's at Barnes & Noble. It's also at select bookstores. I live in Boston, so I've only seen it in the Boston ones, but it's at the Harvard bookstore. It's in Fur Square. So any Barnes & Noble. Also, they can get it on Amazon.com as well as BarnesandNoble.com. And, I found it in a few random bookstores, but if you're curious about where you can get it, just find a Barnes & Noble. Check your local bookstore.
Definitely a great resource. And thanks for coming on the program, Sarah. I'd love to have you back on in the future.
Oh, I'd love to come back. Thank you, Brynn, so much for having me.
Thank you, and have a great day.
You too. Bye-bye.
Bye. That was Sarah Dussault, who is also known on YouTube as Sarah Fit. She has over 100 million views for her channel, and she's also the author of the book, Sarah Fit, Get Skinny Again, The Right Exercises to Get Back Your Dream Body and the Secrets to Living a Fit Life. Her website is sarahfit.com, and it's Sarah with an H.